Faculty members and my fellow student managers. I am Abhishek Saraswat and
my name is Aditya Oak and we are from River Godavari. So how many of you are mechanical engineers? Great. So we will take you through one video which will clearly give you idea about our topic and our product. Lights off please. So how was it? So can anyone tell me which is the parent company of MG Motors? Anyone? Sorry? Anyone? Please raise your hand and speak. Great. Right. You're right. SAIC. It's SAIC. So our topic is entry of MG Motors in Indian automotive market.
Let us come to the content side. We are going to talk about the objective, introduction, Indian automobile industry, and then the marketing strategy, and the CSR policies, and then the conclusion. So let us come on the objective side. Actually, most of us present here usually get fascinated by technology and something like that. And MG is providing us with the same. And we'll see in the upcoming slides why and how the entry of MG Hector, the MG Motors, can create a new segment of its own and can make a difference. Before that, let us come to the timeline of MG Motors. It was set up in 1924 by William Morris, and coming to the 2009, it was acquired by SAIC, the Shanghai Automotive International Corporation. And then coming to the Indian perspective, in 2017, MG invested about 2,200 crores in Halol, Gujarat. That is situated in Halol, and it has a capacity of 80,000 units per annum. And recently, in 27 June, it has launched its first product, MG Hector, in 2019.
So let me take you through Indian automobile industry. The Indian automobile, the market size of Indian automobile industry is around 2.62 crores for year 2018. And the breakup is 80% is two wheelers, 13% is for passenger vehicles, 4% is for commercial, and the last is 3% for three wheeler segment. Next slide. So, can you tell me who is the leader in passenger vehicle segment here? And can anyone tell me why? Why they have 51% market share in? One by one. Okay, let me tell you. The first one is mileage. Second one is low cost of spare parts, right? Third is they have really good penetration in rural market and availability, and they have strong dealership network. So this is why they are leader, and this is what MG Motors is trying, will try to do in next 2 or 3 years. They will create a brand in India. So this is breakup for SUV market size, and the market size for SUV segment is around 8.37 lakhs, and the leader is again Maruti. Previously Mahindra was leader in this segment, but Maruti has, you know, captured the SUV segment also very successfully. And here is addition, one addition, which is today we have all read newspaper, right? So we have Kia Seltos launched today, and which is again a competition of MG Hector right now. Next slide.
Now, coming to the marketing strategy, first of all, let us know about the features, because for MG and being a first product of MG, the features are most important for it, because there are many first in segments for it. We can see that there's a 48-volt hybrid system actually. The hybrid system is that apart from the IC engine, we have the auxiliary electric motor, which will help in increasing the fuel consumption about 12% with it, and it is the first in its segment, and it is a USP of MG Hector, I guess. And then e-call features, God forbid if anyone got encountered with accident, it has an e-call feature. As soon as airbags are deployed, the MG Hector will call a nearest hub, so that your dear ones can get to know about that you have encountered with accidents. And there is a first in segment, it's a 360 degree view camera. There is no any other car that which provides this this feature. And the geofencing also is a very important factor. Suppose you have preset the value that if your car is going beyond that distance, you will get notified that your car is going beyond your border, preset border. The geofencing is also first of its kind. Now, coming to the product, these are the variants, four variants: Style, Super, Smart and Sharp. So MG Hector is differentiated in these four parts.
So coming to pricing part, they are using penetrative pricing strategy in to enter in Indian market, and keeping in mind BS6 regulations. As we know, in 2020 BS6 will be implemented in India. So they have priced themselves. It's a blend of, you know, affordability and great features, which will be really successful in future. Next slide, please. They have invested around 150 crores in setting up their headquarters in Gurugram, and which is also their flagship store in India. And they have around 120 touch points and 60 dealership network till now. And they will expand it to around 250 dealerships in near future. Next slide. So can anyone tell me who is the brand ambassador for MG Hector? Great. So we will have a small video for promotion.
What makes us human? Sometimes it feels like we've forgotten. Maybe we can learn again from someone who's been learning from us.
Welcome, Benedict.
Learn to recognize each other. Hello, MG. Turn on AC.
Turning on AC.
Learn to listen and respond to each other. Hello, MG. Play my favorite music.
Playing your favorite music.
Learning to learn about each other. Say hello to the family, Hector. Open sunroof. Very obliging. Thanks, Hector. That was fun. It's a human thing.
Uh, They have collaborated for women empowerment and for girl child empowerment, and they have collaborated with Tracks NGO for initiative in road safety and to create awareness about clean driving and safe driving.